Okay, Tom Dabernig joins us this morning. Tom, we're racing at Caulfield on Saturday. Race one, Jai McNeil takes the ride on Chicard, drawn barrier 9 over the 1400.
We dropped her back to 1,000 last start down the straight. She's definitely not a straight horse, and I think around the bend and up to 7 furlongs, she can get back to her winning form that she showed at Mornington that day.
In race 3 over 1,100, Military Salute makes his debut. What are you expecting from him first up?
He's a really nice two-year-old. I think if he has his luck in running, he could be thereabouts.
Red Fez is first up from a spell in race 5 over 1,200.
Look, she's definitely got the ability. She hasn't raced since the spring. She may need the run.
Two runners in race 7 over the 2,000, starting with Rotham Heath, who looked a bit disappointing on face value last start.
The track got downgraded to heavy. It wasn't to his liking. He was a little bit disappointing, but I think back to a soft track should suit him, and he's a horse that probably needs to improve.
Golden Mane on the quick backup in that same race?
Look, he's done very well during the week. I was really thrilled with his last start at Flemington. He just over-raced a tad in it, so backing up should help him relax, and I think he can be thereabouts.
Goldoni is first up in race 9 over the mile, drawn out in 16.
Going to be a bit awkward from there and may need the run.
Tips and Beers stays at the track distance where he ran second last start, so he's also on the 9th.
Yeah, I thought that was a really good run. He's probably ready to figure in the money.
Group 1 racing at Morpheville on Saturday. We've got 5 runners on the day. Race 1, last start winner Shining Brook runs over 1,200, drawn barrier 10 of 10. D. Oliver aboard.
She's a really nice filly. D. Oliver is a big bonus, but from barrier 10 she's going to need a little bit of luck.
Dane Hustler runs in race 3, group 3 over 2,500. Good run last start at big odds in the St. Ledger.
Yeah, couldn't have her any fitter. She really stays. And I actually thought in the St. Ledger that she finished it off pretty strong in testing conditions, so she wouldn't be the worst chance in the race.
Star Fashion has been right around the money the past two starts. She runs in race 4 over the 2,000.
She's in excellent order. She's got a hoof on the till, and I think she'll be very hard to beat.
In race 5 over 1,200, Miss Promiscuity is drawn out in barrier 12. She's been in good form this time in with a win in her second placing.
She's got really nice ability, definitely stakes class. Just going to need a little bit of luck from that gate, but she should definitely be around the money.
And last but not least, Gregor's runs in race 7. The Group 1 Goodwood, of course, narrowly defeated in the Group 1 Sangster last start. She gets her chance to atone here.
I actually thought she won watching it live. It was an excellent run. You probably wouldn't get a tougher mare, and I think she's definitely got a liking for the track and distance. She'll be riding it.
So your best of the weekend, Tom?
I'd have to stick with Star Fashion. I think she's really ready to win.